Welcome to Social Fabric. So, music and clothing have always been an extremely important part of America's history. In the beginning, it was the music and the clothing of the Europeans who colonized our country. And then it became the music and the clothing of the immigrants who settled in this country as we pressed the border west. But the truth of the matter is, it wasn't until the very beginning of the 20th century that America came to have her own identifiable music and her own identifiable clothing. We call this show Social Fabric. Why? Well, fabric has two really interesting definitions. The first, of course, is the common one. It's about cloth, material, textiles. But the second definition of fabric is the feeling of or the structure of a society or a culture. So when we talk about the fabric of our society, it's a metaphor for the cloth that binds us all. So I began to think, what if the social fabric of our country helped to determine who the great artists were, and that the great artists in turn helped to define the social fabric of our country? If that were the case, I was wondering, what kind of fabrics or costumes did those artists wear? It turns out the answer to that question is that decade by decade, the social fabric of the United States of America has changed, the artists have changed, and their costumes have changed. So let's start in the 1920s. The 1920s were a decade filled with conflict. There was the conflict between new and old, city and rural, rich and poor, liberal and fundamentals. But ultimately, the 1920s is the first decade in the history of our country to have a nickname. We called it the Roaring Twenties, or the Jazz Age, because in this decade, we had jazz bands, raccoon coats, and flappers.
Five-foot-two, eyes of blue, but oh, what those 5 feet could do. Has anybody seen my girl? A turned up nose, turned down hose, I never had no other bows. Has anybody seen my girl? Now if you run into a 5 foot 2, a comfort with the fur, a diamond rings, and all those things. Bet your life of it is in her butt. Could she will? Could she love? Could she cool? Has anybody seen my gal? Has anybody seen?
In 1929, the stock market crashed, and the 1930s was a very depressed decade, a greatly depressed decade. The social fabric of this country was disheartened and depressed. But sometimes, out of the greatest sadness comes some of the greatest music, and such is the case with the decade of the 1930s. Two great songwriters emerge in the 1930s who define this decade for us. They are Harold Arlen and Hoagy Carmichael. Did you know that Harold Arlen wrote over 500 songs? One of them was called Paper Moon. And Hoagy Carmichael was considered to be the single most important songwriter in the 1930s. And believe it or not, it's Hoagy Carmichael who, in 1930, wrote Georgia on My Mind. So, though no one had a barrel of money, they had a barrel of great songs that formed the very core of the great American songbook. And Molly Miller.
Georgia, the whole day through, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Oh, I said, Georgia, Georgia, a song of you comes as sweet and clear as moonlight through the vines. Other eyes smile tenderly, still in peaceful dreams I see the road leading.
welcome to the 1940s. Long before the 1940s, Mark Twain said, clothes make the man. But you know what? I think he was prescient, because I think he was thinking about Duke Ellington, and I think he was thinking about the first king of the night, Nat King Cole. Duke Ellington in his top hat and his white tie and his tails. Nat King Cole, of course, the essence of high style, always in his perfect suit. Though the 1940s was filled with World War II, song rose up because of the harmonies, the melodies, and the rhythms of Duke Ellington, the glorious voice of Ella Fitzgerald, and the utter perfection of Nat King Cole.
Very strange, enchanted boy. A boy who wandered very far, very far, over land and sea. A little shy and sad of eye, but very wise was he. And then one day, one magic day, he passed my way. That day we spoke of many things, fools and kings. This he said to me, the greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved in return. The greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved. return.
REVEL Day. Here comes the cornucopia of rock and roll. It's the 1950s, and a plethora of songs spilled out. So, at the beginning of the 1950s, when rock and roll was really taking hold, it was clear that the rock musicians and their clothing were going to be married as one. And that, in fact, was the case. Song after song spilled out in this decade. Artist after artist made his or her impact. It was an extraordinary time in the fabric of this country with this new music coming. In the beginning, there was Elvis, the next king. Elvis sneered his lip, and Elvis had what was for the time considered to be X-rated moves. But that isn't why he was called the king. That royal moniker came to him because of the way he dressed. Elvis Presley invented the rock star equation. Fashion plus hip thrust plus song equals fame.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Hey, snooping around my door.
Television sets came into the home. And when television sets came into the home, people could actually see their idols, not just the rock stars, not just the musicians, not just the television personalities or the politicians or the musicians, but they could also see fictional characters come to life in their own homes. Who could ever forget the indelible impression left by Natalie Wood playing Maria in the bridal shop of Leonard Bernstein's West Side Story?
Thank you.
Julie Rogers. The 1960s. Rock and roll had an enormous impact on the social fabric of the 1960s. But the social fabric of the 1960s also had an equally as important impact on rock and roll. Two interesting things happened in the world of rock and roll. You remember this book that Marshall McLuhan wrote called The Medium is the Message. Well, one thing that happened in the world of rock and roll is that the message of the rock artists became indelibly connected to the way they looked. It was a double message that they were sending out. The other thing that happened to rock and roll in the 1960s was that it became segmented. There was surf rock, where the fashion was, as the Beach Boys wore, identical vertical pinstripe shirts while seated on the hood of a Woody. There was blues rock. Think of Etta James and her short platinum hair and her sleeveless tiny black cocktail dress. There was hard rock. Think of Janis Joplin with her I don't care what I wear, feather boas, lavender tinted granny glasses, a million rings, a million tattoos. And there was folk rock, the ultimate bohemian New Yorker, Bob Dylan, with his work boots, his jeans, and his leather jacket, the 1960s.
Hey!
I give you nearly everything that a man possibly can. Baby, you know I did it. And each time I tell myself that I think that I had enough, oh, I'm gonna show you, baby, that this man is so enough to never say, come on, come on, come on, come on, and take it, take another little piece of my heart now, baby. Break another little bit of my heart now, darling, yeah, yeah, have another little bit of my heart now, baby. You know you got it if it makes you feel good. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, you're out there on the street looking good, but baby, you know that that ain't right. No, 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 no. Then never, 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 never would I let you cry, baby. Hey, cause you know that ain't right, so listen. The East time I tell myself that I can't stand the pain. You hold me in your arms and I'll sing it once again. I sing, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, and sing it. Take another little piece of my heart now, baby. Break another little bit of my heart now, darling. Yeah, 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 yeah. Have another little bit of mine now, baby, yeah. You know you got it if it makes you feel good.
REVEL Day and the band, ERIK and Matt, Steve and Molly. A great band. Music, changes us, and often it changes us for the better. But sometimes change in our interiors comes from a variety of different places. I'm thinking now of the kind of change that happens when you can encounter somebody who is good, who is astonishingly good. A man who leads by pure thought and an ethical center, and by doing so creates change in his community and in his followers. This is for you, John Van de Kamp.
Come gather around, people, wherever you roam, and admit that the waters around you have grown. Accept that soon you'll be drenched to the bone. And if your time to you is worth saving, you better start swimming or you'll sink like a stone. For the times, they are a-changing. Come writers and critics who prophesize with your pen, and keep your eyes wide, the chance won't come again. But don't, we're still in spin, and there's no telling who we'll be naming.
Times, they are a-changing.
Thank you, Rachel.
Come, senators, congressmen, please heed the call. Don't stand in the doorway, don't block up the hall. For he who is hurt is the one who has stalled. There's a battle outside that is raging. He'll soon tear down the windows and shatter the walls. For the times, they are a-changing. Come mothers and fathers throughout the land, And don't criticize what you can't understand. Your sons and your daughters are beyond your command. The old road is rapidly aging. Well, get out the new one if you can't lend a hand, 'cause the times, they are a-changing. The line, it is strong. The spell, it is cast. The slow ones now will one day be fast. And the present soon will one day be last in the past. The order is rapidly fading. And the first ones now will one day be last, 'cause the times, they are a-changing.
Keep your eyes wide, the chance won't come again, is the kind of wisdom that our friend John preached. So, this building was built in the 1970s, but we're here tonight because our friends Stephanie and Greg McLemore now own this building. And just as music takes you to new places around the city and asks you to explore yourselves and your lives and the city through music, Greg and Stephanie invited us all up here tonight before they begin construction on their luxury condominium so that we too could have an opportunity to see this city 360 degrees through new eyes and a new vision. Greg and Stephanie have been supporters and members since the inception of MUSE, and we're deeply grateful to them for hosting us here this evening. All right, Jason, I need you out here. Come here, Jason. Now, I just want to ask you something. Okay, do it from back here. Jason, show us 1970. So I couldn't resist this next ultimate aspect of the social fabric of the 70s, disco. Go. So the 1980s, the three kings of the Bible were Melchior, Caspar, and Balthazar, but the three kings of popular music in this country were Nat King Cole, Elvis, and Michael. Michael Jackson said this: "If fashion says not to do it, it's a must for me." Michael Jackson got to be called the King of Pop again, the moniker King, because he rose up through his wardrobe to royalty. Michael Jackson had three extraordinary artistic things which made him soar: an unmatched vocal ability, dancing that stunned Baryshnikov, and an incredible wardrobe.
Listen. She was more like a beauty queen from a movie scene. I said, oh my, but do you mean I am the one who would dance on the floor in the round? She said, I am the one who would dance on the floor in the round. Yeah. Listen. She told me her name was Billie Jean, and she crossed the scene with every head turned, with eyes that dreamed of being the one who would dance on the floor in the round. Talk to the people, baby. Come on, say it. Yeah.
People always told me, be careful what you do. Don't go around breaking young girls' hearts. And mama always told me,
be careful who you love.
Be careful what you do, cause a lie becomes a truth.
Billie Jean is not my lover. She's just a girl who says that I am the one. But the kid is not my son. She said what? She said I am the one. But the kid is not my son. Yeah. For 40 days and for 40 nights, the law was on her side. But who can stand when she's in demand? Her screams and blips, cause we dance on the floor in the round. So take my strong advice, just remember to always think twice. Do think twice.
Think twice.
Hey, she told me, baby, we dance for three. Then she looked at me, she showed a photo of baby crying. Eyes were like mine, cause we dance on the floor in the round. Yeah, one more time, baby, come on, say what?
People always told me,
be careful what you do.
Don't go around bringing young girls' hearts. And mama always told me,
be careful who you love.
Be careful what you do,
cause
the lie becomes the truth.
I am the one, but the kid is not my son. Hey, say Billie Jean, say what?
Billie Jean is not my lover.
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 Where would America be without the popular song? In my opinion, there is no art form like it. Can you stand online in a supermarket waiting to check out and just conjure up a novel? No. But will a song pop into your mind? Yes. Will you be in the middle of doing the laundry and suddenly you can't get a certain painting out of your mind? No. You got problems, buddy. But a song can sneak in your basement, in your laundry room. A song can sneak in where a novel can't, where a poem cannot, where not even a movie can. Songs have sneaky ways of getting inside of us, running inside of our heads all day long. How often do you end up saying to a friend or to a partner, I just couldn't get this song out of my head all day? That doesn't happen with any other art form except the popular song. Some popular songs become so iconic in our social fabric that we come to call them anthems, not national anthems, popular song anthems. Almost all of them can be identified with artists who had absolute control over their fashion sense. The artist who invented performing live and had a drop-dead fashion sense was the late, great Chuck Berry. Chuck Berry did a lot for this world musically, but we leave you tonight with a song which, while it was written in 1958, is really timeless.
Now back in Louisiana, next to New Orleans, whipping in the woods and off the mist of trees. They lived to get the cabin made of earth and wood. They lived a country boy named Johnny B. Good. He never learned to read and write and play so well, but he could play the guitar like ringing the bell. Sing, go, go, Johnny, go, 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 Johnny, go, 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 Johnny, go, 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 Johnny, go, go. Johnny be good, Johnny be good, Johnny be good.
He used to carry his guitar in a gunny sack, sit down by the dream of the railroad track.
Yeah, yeah.
Only engineer would see him sitting by the sheep, jumping to the rhythm that the drivers made. All the people passing by, they would stop and say, oh my, the little country boy could play. Go, go,
go, Johnny, go, 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 Johnny, go, 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 Johnny, go, 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 Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go, go.
Johnny be good,
Johnny be good.
Come on, Alicia.
Mama told him, son, you'll be a man. You will be the leader of a big old band. Man, it's on there, it'll play like.
Hey, hey.
It's on. Johnny be good tonight.
Go, 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 Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, be good.
Thank you. We love you. See you May 8th at the ice skating rink.